Is there anything that you can tell us specifically about what kind of evidence her family and the administration received over the weekend from the Islamic State, and what you know about when and how she died?
Julie, let me begin by restating something that the president indicated in the written statement that we issued earlier today, which is simply that the thoughts and prayers of everybody who works here at the White House are with the Mueller family at this time. That includes, of course, Kayla's parents, Carl and Marcia Mueller. It includes her brother Eric and his family and all those who worked with Kayla in her all-too-short life. She is somebody who dedicated her life to serving others. And not just serving other people, but serving those who were in crisis situations, who faced dire circumstances and were relying on the generosity and kindness of fellow human beings to try to meet their needs. And Kayla was a young woman who was willing to put herself in harm's way to try to offer that relief. She saw this as a way to honor the God that she worshiped. And I will indicate that I was personally moved by her comments that that she saw God in the eyes of people who were dealing with terrible crisis. That is a particularly profound, wise statement from such a young woman. But I think it does go to the character and generosity of spirit that she embodied. Over the weekend, Kayla's parents received a private message from her ISIL captors with additional information about her death. That information was shared with the intelligence community. They conducted a review and an analysis. And after that analysis was completed, they concluded that Kayla has, in fact, died. And the information that they reviewed did not allow them to arrive at a conclusion about her precise cause of death. But it did allow them to conclude that she had, in fact, died.
Was there any information they were able to glean about when she died?
That's a good question. I do not believe that they were able to arrive at any conclusion about the timing, the precise timing of her death.
Do you know if they were able to rule out whether she was killed in a Jordanian airstrike on Friday, which is what the Islamic State has claimed?
I've seen those claims. Again, the intelligence community did not have a specific assessment about the cause of death. There are some things, however, that I can share with you about this airstrike that I know that ISIL has referenced. And this is something that military officials have indicated as well. The airstrike that was carried out by the Royal Jordanian Air Force on February 6th was against an ISIL weapons compound that group maintained near Raqqa, Syria. This was a facility that had been struck on previous occasions, and it's not unusual for targets like this to be hit more than once. In previous strikes, this facility had been damaged. But like I said, it's not unusual for strikes like this to be carried out once again. The information that we have is that, and again, we have this information because this airstrike was coordinated with the United States military. And the information that we have is that there is no evidence of civilians in the target area prior to the coalition strike taking place. And that certainly would call into question the claims that are made by ISIL. Is not possible to call into question is that ISIL, regardless of her cause of death, is responsible for it. This, after all, is the organization that was holding her against her will. That means they are responsible for her safety and her well-being, and they are therefore responsible for her death.